They're making 50 years.
Making 50
That's
years.
That's a jubilee.
That's insane. 50 yeah. years of PDD. I mean, if we go for a throwback there on PDD, he's the one who came, you know, was producing with Tupac. Was it? Yeah. No, sorry.
Yeah,
Big DD, B.I.G., sorry. Yeah, yeah. My bad. B.I.G., and that was, you know, one of the best, greatest
yeah,
things
Bad
he's
Boys
ever done.
Crew back in the days.
Yeah.
We saw this lady, Lil Kim.
And then he,
Lil Kim.
And he also came up with his own thing, yeah. started doing his own music. Mm. But, you know, he has so much to celebrate. He's done a lot in the entertainment industry. Mm. And so recently, while he celebrated his birthday bash, he invited pretty much the whole entertainment industry.
Yeah, yeah.
And the people that came up and even reunited was Kim Kardashian, Kanye, Jay-Z and Beyoncé.
All of them attended?
So they person? All attended, but yeah. this is the part where, like, P. Diddy was taking a picture and he wanted Jay-Z and Kanye West in the same picture. Yeah. And then there was Pharrell. But Pharrell pretty much was like, didn't even know how to react towards it. Yeah. So you can see there was not much of happiness except yeah. from P. Diddy. Just being happy, but they're both.
I feel that there is no reunion among them. It was
no,
they
had to attend, but that was the chance they managed to talk, because they haven't really got a chance to be in the same place at the same time. And you know, I think this was a perfect time for them to celebrate,
yeah,
and really, you know, talk about what happened, and you know, put back that friendship together, because those two make great music together. As you can see, that's the Kardashians and whatnot that also attended.
Yeah. You think after this birthday party, still they talk now? Do they call each other? Do they?
So I think that it's a start.
It's not to that level that they call each other. Mm. But I
yeah.
think they had a chat.
They had a chat.
Yeah. At least now the friendship is there, and
it's,
the only
it's
person
there.
Who can join them
there
is,
no
is the
friendship.
Likes of Jay-Z and Diddy.
Yeah.
They can't be friendship.
They are.
They're friends. They're friends.
The
you let me tell you.
Everyone is so busy, especially Kanye.
And not only that, and also what Kanye did was beyond silly. What Kanye did, so you know, it's a step. That's all we can say. It's a step that at least now they're talking, and I think after that it will be less awkward for them when they meet, and you know there'll be more conversations.
Yeah.
But the party was crazy. Now I'm gonna tell you guys also about what happened. Mm-hmm. Also, there was a part where Jay-Z hit someone with his phone.
Why?
Yeah, because he was shooting Beyonce dancing. And you know, the whole point is that everyone is you know, putting their phones out, they're excited, they're having
course.
A great
I
time.
Mean, yeah.
And you know, but then this apparently was a little bit too uncomfortable. It was like more of like a waitress or something like that. And that was a bit like, okay, you know,
yeah,
we came here to feel comfortable, to celebrate our friend's birthday bash.
Yeah.
So that was a big thing. So there you go, PDD doing the dance. He's so famous for doing
He has been practicing those
He's
moves
known
for
dancing
time.
Those are some throwback moves.
Yeah, he's got the old school.
There is a time he posted his, I think it was with the Sun, rehearsing these kind of moves. I think they were getting prepared for the party in some type of way.
Yeah. The Sun also gave him a very beautiful portrait. It was a painting of him and his son. But, you know, they look so much alike. So it was half of the face that belonged to the Sun and half of the other face that belonged to BDD. But it was so great. I saw some other videos from Janelle Monáe. You know, Jay-Z, Kardashians, everyone posted.
I'm sure there was a service.
Snoop Dogg, Usher, everybody was
there.
There
was a prayer service there. Kanye West,
prayer
did he have any prayers?
No. That was just pure damn champagne and cigars.
Seriously.
And just, you know get
these
down
days,
with
these
it.
These days I call him Pastor Kanye. So, because the guy is like holding Sunday
service. I must say, I do enjoy Kanye West's album. The whole album is just so brilliant.
Yeah, haven't you checked out the service yet?
I have, and I enjoy it. I enjoy it. I'm telling you, he's giving me all sorts of spiritual love.
You need to watch.
I'm loving
the prayers. Yeah.
Yeah.
The services.
Yeah, and that's how we also like to we go by just watching YouTube where we're listening to a service. Okay, so let's talk about Offset and Cardi B. So recently, Offset's birthday happened. And Cardi B went crazy for Offset. So she ended up giving him
half a million
dollars. Half a million dollars.
And in cash.
Cash. cash, wow, pretty much like bulks of cash that were just set on
but
the table.
But that is their
and
money.
And what she did?
What kind of offering?
No, because you see, there's separate bank accounts, I'm telling you. There is separate bank accounts. And Cardi B right now, I must say, is making way more money than Offset.
Yeah, true that, true.
So
that.
To do something like that, it's just like, you know, and it wasn't, no, it wasn't just giving money. Mm-hmm. It was also the reason why she gave the money. She was like, listen, here's the money, and now we're going to a women's club to, you know, splash it up.
Yeah,
to splash it up. And that's what they did. And there was a video on their Instagram stories where you could see the whole club just full of money on the floor. Yeah, because they were throwing it on the ladies who were dancing.
But I must say that she's making a lot of money this year.
Yeah, she's making lots of money.
I was looking at her daily income, because they earn daily in some type of way. And she's also over $25.
Yeah, yeah.
So
let
you can
me tell
imagine,
you.
Oh, that is like Crimza
money,
annual salary or
something? Money after money. Money after money. So anyways, that's what we have for you on the international scene, yeah, ladies and gents.
Now, on top of that, by the way, talking about international scene.
Yeah.
Have you seen the price of the Spider-Man cap?
Oh, yes. So, I am a huge fan of Spider-Man.
I'm not.
I am, and my son loves him. So Spider-Man's cape is something very, very special, because it's, if you've seen the amount of endorsements and movies, and if we're talking about the original, the first Spider-Man movie, sorry, Superman movie from the man who died of cancer, that's a very special, special cape. And it goes for the endorsement of $200,000.
$200,000. If you convert that to Ugandan shillings, that's how much cream there.
That is insane.
If you convert $200,000 to shillings.
I can't count that money, man.
You can't?
I can't.
Well,
it's too much.
It's a lot of money. It's a lot of money. But it's worth it, because that's the value of it. It has so much treasure. I'm telling you, you know the people who are going to buy that are kids.
I don't watch
there are
Superman.
Some kids who just collect. Collectors are the ones who buy that kind of stuff. Yeah, yeah. But you know what has killed me? There's this thing that's come out where a company is making phones, iPhones. And these are special iPhones. So basically, there's 10 phones of each of that person who's famous in the world. Let's say Michael Jackson. So there's a jacket, very famous jacket, that every small piece is cut off from it and put in two behind in the back of the iPhone. And the iPhone is also made of titanium, and it's very special, and it's like beyond, let's say 10 people who have it. So what I would say, if someone's going to buy something like the cape, I think that company might end up buying it and just cut a small piece and give it to that phone.
Yeah, yeah.
And that phone has a certain warranty, and also it comes with a certificate and everything, and it's very, very, and it's worth about...
You mean they're already on the market?
Yes, already on the market. It's already on the market. So each so there's Beatles. Mm-hmm. There's a collection of the Beatles. There's a collection of Michael Jackson. There's a collection of Steve Jobs. Mm-hmm. He's from his T-shirt, the original shirt that he wore, and it's all beautiful. It's amazing.
I think I'm planning soon to buy an iPhone. So
no, this one is priceless. I think it's about $60,000.
$60,000.
Yeah. That's how. No, it's either 6,000 or 60. I'm not sure, but it's worth that.
I don't
amount.
Think it's 60. It can't be 60. That is too way so
because
much.
Because the phone has more value to it. It's not only titanium,
but,
it's very special.
This is something that you can lose at any time, like any time.
No, well, really. That's true. But
anyway,
they can always make it again for you.
But I'm going to get myself one for Michael Jackson. I don't know how much I have to save, but I'm going to get one from Michael Jackson because I'm a big fan.
Yeah.
And we're going to go in for a break right now, courtesy of Lucky 3. Remember, you can dial *185*88#. Follow prompts and send that to 6,000. Win some money right now as you're enjoying the show. We'll be back with more stories and more music.